In this episode of Physics in Motion, we take you to the Sun and other stars. In another segment, you learned about fission, when unstable atoms break into two. In this segment, you'll see how atomic particles fuse together, appropriately called fusion. It's a cosmic and microscopic event we're just starting to understand. Fusion occurs inside stars, including our own Sun, where extremely high temperatures fuel a powerful nuclear reaction. Fusion occurs at the atomic and subatomic levels when a small, light nucleus fuses with another small, light nucleus. For this to happen, the nuclei have to be moving at very high speeds because the repulsive electrical force between the two positively charged nuclei that would normally cause them to repel each other must be overcome. The binding energy that keeps all those protons and neutrons in the nucleus is released during nuclear fusion, just like it is with nuclear fission. But this time, instead of breaking a nucleus apart, the two atoms' nuclei come together, causing a fusion reaction. The mass of the newly formed nucleus is less than the total mass of the two nuclei coming together. The difference in mass is called the mass defect, and just like with fission, that missing mass is released as energy. This energy, known as the binding energy, was what held the atoms together before the fusion took place. To figure out how much mass goes to energy, we go back to Einstein's famous equation, E is equal to mc squared. Remember, E is binding energy measured in joules, m is for mass defect measured in kilograms, and c is the speed of light, which is 300 million meters per second. If you square it, making it an even larger number, even a minuscule mass defect is equal to a very large amount of energy. Okay, so the most common place in the universe fusion occurs is where? In the stars, including our favorite star, the Sun. Fusion fuels the stars. That's how they emit all that light and heat, and lots of it. Think of it. This has been going on for billions of years. One of two types of fusion reactions we know about is when two hydrogen nuclei meet under these high-speed, high-temperature conditions. Hydrogen has just one proton in the nucleus. The temperatures and kinetic energy are so great, more than 14 million Kelvin, that it overcomes the electrical force. Over the course of three separate reactions, hydrogen nuclei become fused into a helium nucleus with huge amounts of gamma radiation released. This is called a proton-proton chain reaction, also known as stellar nucleosynthesis. This process happens again and again, ultimately causing four hydrogen nuclei to fuse together to finally form a stable helium nucleus and some byproducts. Here's the equation to show nuclear fusion in stars. The starting material, four hydrogen nuclei, is on the left of the reaction arrow. On the right side, the products of the reaction. A helium nucleus with two protons and two neutrons. The byproducts consist of two positrons. Positrons are identical to electrons, but with a positive charge. Two gamma rays and two neutrinos. Neutrinos are extremely small particles with a neutral charge. They typically pass through matter undetected. Neutrinos are often byproducts in nuclear reactions. We can calculate the amount of energy released during a fusion reaction by using E is equal to mc squared. Let's do an example problem. The mass defect between the starting material and the product in the nuclear reaction of hydrogen to form helium in stars is 0.7% of the mass of our starting material. How much energy would be created if 1 kilogram of hydrogen fuses to form helium? The first thing is to determine how much mass is lost in the process. The mass defect is 0.7%, so we have to find 0.7% of our initial starting material. To get the percentage into a decimal value, think of 100% as one whole. To know what 0.7% of a whole is, you simply divide 0.7 by 100 and end up with 0.007. Next, multiply this number by our starting mass, which is 1 kilogram. This gives you how much mass is lost in the process as energy, which is 0.007 kilograms. To get the energy created in the process, we use Einstein's equation to determine the energy equivalent for this amount of mass. So, binding energy is equal to mass defect times the speed of light squared. We substitute in the mass from above, 0.007 kilograms, and the speed of light for c, which is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, and then we square it. We end up with a value of 6.3 × 10⁴ joules of energy that's created in the fusion of just 1 kilogram of hydrogen. This amount of energy is greater than what 100 kilotons of TNT puts out when it explodes. Think about that. 0.007 kilograms of hydrogen has more energy than 100 kilotons of TNT. The mass defect is only 0.7% of the original mass of the individual protons. But due to the large amount of mass in stars, this very small amount of mass adds to an astronomical amount of energy in stars. The nuclear fusion that occurs in the Sun is called thermonuclear fusion because it happens at very high temperatures. The nuclear fusion we're talking about here takes place in the core of the Sun. The gamma rays that are produced in the reaction interact with free electrons within the solar core and are scattered. There's so much scattering of the gamma rays that it takes nearly 170,000 years for gamma rays to make it out of the inner 75% of the Sun. And once the gamma rays make it out of that inner core, they're constantly absorbed and re-emitted by other particles in the outer portion of the Sun. The gamma rays lose energy, and most of the radiation that eventually leaves the Sun is in the ultraviolet, visible, and infrared range of light. The radiation the Sun emits travels at the speed of light, that's 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, and reaches the Earth in just a little over 8 minutes. Seems like a short amount of time when considering the entire time from the gamma rays are created until the time that energy reaches us. It's more than 170,000 years. Scientists agree that the original matter in the early universe was all hydrogen and helium, which are the two lightest atomic nuclei. Scientists say that nuclei could form as early as several seconds after the Big Bang, but it took another 300,000 years for atoms to first form. The universe was just too hot for electrons to be captured by nuclei. Then it was hydrogen and helium atoms that formed first. As nuclear fusion continues in the cores of stars, heavier elements form. Elements with atomic numbers heavier than 26, which is iron, are formed during supernovas. Supernovas are explosions of large stars as they die. These elements are blasted outward at velocities as much as 10% the speed of light. That's 18,600 miles per second. This material is the foundation for new stars and new solar systems like our own. These elements form new planets. This means that all the atoms that make up your body were created in the core of a star after probably 3 or more supernovas. There's still a lot we don't know about fusion. As a powerful natural phenomenon, understanding fusion is a challenge for future scientists to explore. That's it for this segment of Physics in Motion, and we'll see you next time.
For more practice problems, lab activities, and note-taking guides, check out the Physics in Motion Toolkit.